Hello, myself Nivesha Goswami. You are welcome in lecture of bevel gear. So first of all, what is bevel gear? So bevel gear is gear when shaft axis of two gears are at some angle. So these type of gears are known as bevel angle. Again, there is some classification of bevel gear, straight bevel gear and meter gear. So straight bevel gears are those gear when teeth of gears are parallel to shaft axis intersect with each other. So these type of gears are known as straight bevel gear. Again, meter gear. So here you can see in this diagram, when shaft axis of two gears are at right angle with each other, so this is the special case known as meter gears. Here theta p1, theta p2 are indicates pitch angle for pinion and pitch angle for gear. Again, theta s is sharp angle between two sharp axes, and dp and dz indicates pitch diameter for pinion and gear, and velocity ratio is given by dz by dp is equal to tz by dp is equal to np by ng. So here g indicates for gear and p indicates for pinion. Again, what is standard formula for pitch angle? So here theta p1 is equal to sine theta into shaft axis angle divided by velocity ratio plus cos of theta s. Similarly, pitch angle for gear is given by tan theta p2 is equal to sine theta s divided by 1 upon vr plus cos theta s. Again, what are the equivalent number of teeth in case of bevel gear? So this is equal to t into sec theta p. T is actual number of teeth for gear or on gear, and theta p, you can put theta p1 for pinion, theta p2 for gear. So you can find out equivalent number of teeth for pinion and gear. Next is here Lewis equation. So why I have written here modified Lewis equation? Because in bevel gear, there one factor is very important. So this is known as bevel factors, and it is given by L minus V divided by L. So when tangential load is equate with your modified Lewis equation, so WT is equal to sigma O. What is sigma O? Allowable static stress multiplied by velocity factor, it is denoted by CV, multiplied by B. B is your phase width, pi is constant 3.14, M is your module, YDS is your modified tooth form factor with respect to equivalent number of teeth. Okay. And L minus V is divided by L is your Lewis factor. Next is your slant height. So slant height of pitch cone, or you can say that cone distance, is given by under root of dz by 2 whole square plus dp by 2 whole square. So you, by using diameter for pinion and diameter for gear, if both the diameters will be given, so you can find out slant height. So here again, dz is indicate for pitch diameter for gear. Similarly, dp is pitch diameter for pinion. And factor I have highlighted with red color, L minus V divided by L is known as bevel factor. So these are the important terminology which is used in bevel gear. So here we will complete design of bevel gear by using one numerical example. So here you can see a pair of cast iron bevel gear connect two shaft at right angle. So shaft axis are at right angle, means theta s is equal to 90 degree. Similarly, pitch diameter of pinion and gears are 80 and 100 mm. So diameter for pinion, dp is equal to 80 and dz is equal to 100. The tooth profile of gears are of 14 and half degree of composite form. So what is the 14 and a half degree? This indicates that this is your pressure angle. So pressure angle is given 14 and a half composite form, right? The allowable static stress for both the gears is 55 megapascal. If the pinion transmit 2.75 kilowatt at 1100 rpm, means what is the power capacity is given? 2.75 kilowatt, right? And rpm for pinion is given 1100 rpm. So what we have to find out? Find module and number of teeth on each gear from the standpoint of strength. Strength means WT, tangential strength, tangential load. And check the design form from the standpoint of wear, take surface endurance limit as 630 megapascal and modulus of velocity for cast iron is 84 kN per mm square. So these are the given data. First of all, we will write given data, and then we will write what you have to find, and then we will follow the procedure how we have to solve this problem. So given data, theta is equal to 90 degree, dp is equal to 80 mm, dz 100 mm, phi is pressure angle 40.5 degree, sigma op is equal to sigma og, means static allowable static stress for pinion and for gear is equal to 55 megapascal. So we will convert into newton per mm square. Similarly, power transmission 2.75 kilowatt, so 2750 watt. Np is equal to 1100 rpm of pinion. Sigma es endurance strength is equal to 630 megapascal, and ep and eg is equal to 84 kilo newton. So these are given data. Now First of all, what you have to find? So see here, you have to find out module and number of teeth on gear. Each gear means on pinion and on gear. So we will follow procedure. First of all, we required angles for pitch angle for pinion and pitch angle for gear. Okay. So since shaft are right angle, so theta is equal to 90 degree. So when you will put values in this equation, theta p1 is equal to sine theta s divided by vr plus cos theta s. Okay, so here theta s is 90 degree, so sine 90 is 1 and cos 90 is 0. So what will happen? This is equal to 1 upon vr. So I have used this equation here. So you can see here theta p1 is equal to tan inverse of 1 upon vr. So this is equal to tan inverse of what is the velocity ratio? Diameter of gear divided by diameter of pinion. So pinion diameter will come upper side and dz will be in lower end. So this is equal to 38.66 degree. Now pitch angle for the gear. So theta p2, how we will find out? Shaft angle are at 90 degree. So we can find out theta p2 is equal to 90 minus 38.66 degree. So you will get pitch angle for gear. Now next step is we have to calculate formative number of teeth. So how, what is the formula for formative number of teeth? So formative number of teeth is equal to tp into sec theta p1. P1 is here angle for pinion, pitch angle for pinion. So we will put all values. Now you can see here I have written one relation, t is equal to d by m, or you can say that module is equal to diameter, pitch circle diameter divided by number of teeth on same condition. So what is the module? D by t. So t is equal to d by m. So I have just taken this value from there. So tp is equal to dp divided by m. So I have put this value in this equation. Similarly, formative or equivalent number of teeth on gear in the same way. So this is equal to dg divided by m multiplied by sec of 51.34, because what is the pitch angle for gear? It was 51.34. So you will get these equations. Now what is the next step? Here in this case, both the pinion and gear are made of same material, so pinion will be weaker. Okay, so design, on what basis we will do design? So on pinion basis we will do the design, or we will follow the procedure. And what is the pressure angle given? Pressure angle is given 40.5 composite teeth. Okay, so for this there is tooth form factor is fixed. So this is the fixed equation or mathematical formula. Y dash P is equal to 0.124 minus 0.684 divided by TEP. So TEP is equivalent number of teeth for pinion. So this is equal to, you will get 0.124 minus 0.00668 m. Okay. Now what is the next step? You have to find out velocity ratio. So for velocity ratio, you have to find out first of all, pitch line velocity. So what is the pitch line velocity? Pitch line velocity or rubbing velocity is equal to V is equal to pi dp np by 60. So we will put the value of DP and P, you will get the rubbing velocity. So this is equal to 4.6 meter per second. Next is velocity factor. So what is the velocity factor? So for this case, velocity factor is equal to 6 divided by 6 plus V. So this is again mathematical equation. So after finding out your velocity, pitch line velocity, we will put this value in this equation. So you will get CV is equal to 0.566. Okay. Next step is, because in case of wobble gear, we have to find out wobble factor. So wobble factor, what was the wobble factor? L minus V divided by V. Okay. So how to find out wobble factor? So for that, we require slant height. L is here, slant height. And slant height formula is already we have discussed in starting. So this is equal to under root of dg by 2 square plus dp by 2 square. So we will put this value. So we will get L is equal to 64 mm. Now, in this equation or in this question, face width is not given. So we will take, we can take one third d face width. We can take one third of slant height of pitch cone. Okay. So here D is equal to L by 3. So this is equal to 64 divided by 3 is equal to 21.3 is so approximate value is 22 mm. Now, what was power is given. So what is the relation between power and torque? So power is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. And T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi NP. Why we are taking here NP? Because we are finding torque for pinion. So that's why we are taking NP. So we will put all value in this equation. So we will get the torque is equal to 23,870 Nm. Okay, you can convert in Newton meter also. And what is the tangential load? So load is equal to torque divided by DP by 2. So this is equal to 597 Nm. Next step is we have to find out module, right? So we will equate WT is equal to Lewis equation, or you can say that modified Lewis equation. So WT is equal to sigma OP, OP for pinion, multiplied by CV, we have already find out, multiplied by B, multiplied by pi M, multiplied by pi dash P, y dash P, multiplied by wobble factor. So when you will put this, what was the WT? So here you can see that WT is equal to 597 Newton. So 597 is equal to 55 multiplied by CV. CV we have already calculated here, 0.566. So you can put this value in this equation. What was the B? B is equal to 22. Pi is constant. M is equal to, we have to find out M. And Y dash P, we obtain 0.124 minus 0.00668 m multiplied by L minus V. So what was the L? L is equal to 64. What was the B? B was the 22 divided by 64. So when you will put all these data, you will get this equation 175 m minus 9.43 m squared. So why solving this method or this equation can be solved by hit and trial method only. So when we will solve this equation, so we will get module is equal to 5 mm. Okay, so this is equal to module. Now, how to find out number of teeth on pinion and on gear? Okay, so what is the number of teeth on pinion? So TP is equal to, we know the relation, module is equal to DP by DP. So TP is equal to DP by M. So you will get 16 number of teeth on pinion. Similarly, number of teeth on gear is equal to 20 by equating all parameters in this equation. Now, you have to check design for wear. Okay, so we have to find out maximum wear load in case of wobble gear. Okay, so what is the load stress factor? So again, this is the mathematical formula and this is the standard formula. K is equal to sigma ES whole square multiplied by sine phi, phi is here pressure angle, divided by 1.4 and multiplied by 1 upon EP plus 1 upon EG. So EP and EG indicates that Young modulus of elasticity for pinion and for gear, and these values are given. So we will all put all values in this equation. So by using this equation, you can find load stress factor, which is indicated by capital K. And what is the next step? After finding out that load stress factor, you can find out ratio factor, and ratio factor is indicated by Q, capital Q. And capital Q is given by 2 times of number of teeth, equivalent number of teeth on gear divided by number of teeth on gear plus number of teeth on pinion. So by putting all, we have all data. So we have to just put this value. So we can find out 1.22. And what is the maximum or limiting load for wear? So maximum load for wear is equal to dpvqk divided by cos theta p1, because we are designing on basis of pinion, right? So we will put dp is equal to 80 multiplied by b is equal to 22 multiplied by q we have find out 1.22 multiplied by 1.687 divided by cos of 38.66 degree. So this is equal to 4640 newton. So how to find out our design is safe? If this wear load limiting or maximum wear load is more than as compared to tangential load, then your design is safe. So we know what was the tangential load. So tangential load was 597 newton. And what we have obtained in this case of wear load, 4640 newton. So what obvious, 4640 newton is greater than 590 newton. Means whatever we have, all parameter we have considered, we have calculated. So these all parameters satisfy our design. So wear load is more than your tangential load, so your design is safe. So this is the last condition. Thank you.